Hello and welcome to my channel. This is my first attempt to repair this Bluetooth helmet. This is from Plantronics. This is Plantronics, my earpiece, and it has a major defect right here on this button. This button is also pressed for pairing and mine functions. This is another helmet from spare parts. To use, and I want to use this button and replace it right here. I'm going to hot air this solder with hot air and protect with some Krypton tape. And I want to transfer this button from here to my functional helmet. This helmet has another issues. I think it's microprocessor involved in here, and I don't have this chip for spare replace. So I'm going to desolder this under the microscope, and we'll continue with this. We'll attempt to repair this helmet. Now I'm putting some Krypton tape to prevent overheating this PCB, and I hope it will be a good repair. I don't know, I will see right away. It might take some time, and I have to protect this element from the hot air gun. It has some cables, and I'm putting here over the microscope to see what happened, because it has very very tiny components, very very small components, and I'm using a microscope to see what I'm doing here. As I said, I'm protecting. Okay, I want to record this, and I also recording this on the microscope to see the exact process of being repaired. Now it's protected from the hot glue gun, and I will put some flux right here. This is my flux. I don't know how good it is, and I want to adjust in this recipient. Okay, let's see if this work. I put the flux over here. Oh, that's a lot of flux, but I'm hoping to do its best. I'm powering my hot air gun, and let's see if we'll succeed with this. This procedure, I've never done it before, so it might be a challenge, but I like challenges much. As you can see, it has a lot of flux right here. I want to put some more extra flux from here to these contacts on the sideway. And I'm hoping I will. It's too powerful. I think I'm using these scissors to take the button down. From here, only the button I want to take down. And it's around 300 degrees hot in here. Maybe I will lower the temperature, and I'm not using the microscope because I have to be very careful with this, because this is the good board. This is my good board, so I have to be very very careful when I'm desoldering this part. Now it's too hot. Almost done it. I missed. There is too much flux, and I have to block this area from not moving. These are the four mics, and I'm blocking this area for not moving. I will make another attempt. Now it has to work. The button is down, but it also damaged this little board, because it has too much temperature, and the glue under the knit, it has been dissolved. I will make another attempt here to put it on the microscope. I'm putting under the microscope to see what have I done. It has four contacts. It has four contacts right this way there, and I want to put it right here under the microscope and solder in the proper way. These tiny holes are very, let me see. I think I damaged. Maybe I will try with my other tool. This is my other tool, and I don't know. I'm putting the amount of flux right here on the contacts. This button must be replaced as well. And this is a very little. Now I see this button was. You see those tiny jumpers, tiny, very tiny. This. Look at this. This is bothering me to desolder properly. So if I want to desolder, I have to make a lot of adjustments, and I don't know if I don't have enough light. Let me put some light in here. I want to clean the area. I think it's too much heat. Maybe right now it's a good way to start to clean this. Let me check this item. I don't know if it will work. No, this is not working. I need something much thinner like this to remove all this. And now let me put here another special flux for special. I'm using my needle, this needle. It's used for this kind of operation. Okay, let's remove this one and place this one. This is kind of a solid and liquid paste. Let me see how it works. Oh, so it works like this. This is just a test to see how it solidizes, and is working very well. And now the final test is to, this is the hard way. This is very hard. As you can see on YouTube, there is nothing like. This is a way too different to make it yourself. If you saw some videos, it is nothing like in those videos. It is very hard to maintain this kind of precision. So this is the first step. The second step is to desolder this wire, this one. I want to desolder with this. I don't know if it's possible. Let me try another way. No, cannot be done. Cannot be done. In this way, this is the hard way. Yes, this tiny button has been unsoldered. Now it must be cleaned, but the chance of succeed is very small. Very small. Da! Okay, let's see. Let's continue this. This is my setup. I think to align this with the display. I'm putting the recording on, and now I'm placing this tiny connector, this tiny button. Let me see if it's. I have to check this is if it has a good cleaning. I don't know. It's good. Yeah, this is messy. This is messed up. I don't know if this button will work, but I have to give a try and put it right there on the spot and try to solder with that kind of solid copper. This is a lot of plastic here, and I don't know if it will fit back in there. Don't know how to place this. As you can see, this is very hard job. I don't know how are they doing it on the internet. On the side, it doesn't align well. It isn't aligned. I'm trying to do my best here, but how the succeeds. I will try to align this, and then with my hot glue gun with around 128 degrees. I hope it will work. Now stay here, maybe manner. Okay, let's power on my heat gun and hope it's doing Let me verify if this button align here. I don't know. I have to put on the 140 degrees because this is copper. This is a solid flux. This is solid about 103. Let me check here. I will use 180. This is it. This is the moment of truth. This is the right. Let me see if we'll burn out. No, I have to give some more heat. No, more air. And let's see what happens. There you go. Come on, work. Please work. Yes, it stayed. It's staying right here, but I'm detecting some debris. Let me check if the button still works. No, the button doesn't. No, the button is working, and it's working. It's like working. Yes. Let me take this part. This is a impurity. This tiny. Let me clean this up with some alcohol paste. Alcohol. Let me clean this. This is okay. Let me power this on. On one connect. No, the button doesn't work. The button is not working. So this was a failure. This is a failure. Failure repair. Failed repair. It has a good solder. Good solder, but it's broken. It's a broken one. As you see, the glue under the knees, it somehow stayed, but look at here. It's not doing anything. This button is working. Let me see if this button, this is a pairing button, and it doesn't. Let me check this one. This is the old button. You see, it snaps. I've lost it.